Christ Center, Christ City, tunaendelea pamoja, tukitukuza Mungu, tukijipanga wa kurudi kwake. So karibu, ukaweza kubarikiwa pamoja nasi as we proceed. My name is Reverend Dr. Kimani, and I fear the Lord. I'm humbled in His presence. In this place, I worship Him. And I have a dear wife with me here who can raise... Hey, leo tuivaa the same. Okay. Wana sifuwe sana. Inua mkono ukasalimia wapendwa katika jina la Yesu. Na Bwana akubariki sana kwa kuwa msaada katika maisha yangu na katika huduma ya Kristo. Bwana wabariki sana na watendee mema. Kabla sijaingia katika nafasi hiyo, nataka kutaja mambo mawili ambao nataka tuweze kuweka katika mawazo. Na mambo hayo ni kuhusu jambo hilo tumelisema Ramini Church. Mkutano huo wa Sunday, we are going to have all the mini church leaders, and we are going to be discussing about how to grow our mini churches spiritually, and how to what activities are we going to engage in that are in line with the purposes of God. So itakuwa ni a small assignment too. As you go, kabla Sunday ifike, mukuje na mbinu mbili za activities ambazo mnaweza fanya kama mini church, na pia huwe mmeomba kwa sababu ya mkutano huo, na pia tuwe na nafasi ya kujua vile tunaweza kuwa kiroho. So tunaongea mambo ya kiroho na activities ambazo tunaweza jenga ufalme nazo katika kanisa hilo letu. Najua tuna mipango mingi katika our churches to help one another socially, but we must also look at that angle and be able to move forward. So you are most welcome. The ladies council, the church council, and of course the pastoral team will be sitting together for a serious way forward in this season of harvest. We must be able to do something powerful. So I hope you're clear kabisa na hakuna mtu ambaye atakaye sahau. Kabla sijasonga pia, nataka ni karibisha mmoja wetu ambaye ako Purity. Yuko kwa hii nyumba Purity? Yes, yes, songa hapa mbele. Chapia makofi mazuri Purity katika jina la Yesu. Purity has been one of us, one of our daughters, and she's getting married in the coming month on 20th of July. 20th of July, atakuwa anaolewa na atasema pahali atakuwa akiolewa na yule atakaye muoa. Kwa sababu tumepokea apologies from the brother, the pastor, the reverend of his church is being ordained today. So they requested that he be absent for purposes of that occasion. So we are very much informed and aware, and there is a lot of light in that direction, and we want to bless and have our goodwill on Purity as she prepares for her wedding on 20th. So apparently this year's marriages is because they are away. Next year, tutakuwa bumper to bumper hapa. Bwana asifuwe sana. Hallelujah. Bwana asifuwe sana. So right now, wacha tupande tu kwa machozi. Wakati wetu wa kuvuna, we shall harvest rejoicing. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So Purity, tusalimie na tuambie majina ya mpenzi wako na pahali harusi itakuwa, na kama bado iko ama unasema namna gani.
Praise God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Amen. Purity Wajiro, nimeokoka, Yesu ni Bwana. As Reverend have stated, my wedding is on 20th of July, and my love is David Wanyoike. He is from Nakuru, and my wedding will be there. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na wakaribisha sana. Nitazidi kuwakaribisha. Be blessed.
Amen. 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 So one of these days, utahakikisha kabla the third. This is the first announcement. The second one, make sure Wanyoike is around so that we can also appreciate him and he can also invite us. Bwana bariki sana. Wasalimu wote katika jina. Mpe makofi mazuri kwa sababu ya ushindi Getting to a holy matrimony is not a small matter to be taken for granted. So we bless God even for that blessing, even in our midst, we bless Jehovah. Now, they have talked about the VOV. VOV, inamaanisha nini? Voice of? Najua kuna changamoto, voice of angels, voice of valor, vessels of valor, voice of hope. Hii hapa vizi kuna kazi mingi. So this one is voice of, or even the voice of valor, voice ya youth. Bwana asifiwe sana. Ni actually, that's what it means. Voice of youth. So voice of youth, wako na worship experience. Na si ati ni yao, ni yetu. Because they are our ministry in this church. So on Friday, it is going to be a day like not like none other. That there will be worship and praise in this platform that you have not seen in the recent past. We are going to have every manner of effect and power and praise. And those who know what God can do, we are going to be there. And I know that we have a small budget that we are doing for them because they are saying we are not going to do it like you have done. Sasa hao ndio wameanza kutuambia, we are not your parents. They are saying we are not your parents. So we are accepting they are not like our parents. So today we are saying we want to make that effect, that event and that function and that purpose to be a function of power in terms of visual, in terms of every form. And they are desirous of having something they are calling smoke machine, and they're desiring of having something they are calling. So when we look at the budget, it's coming to about 58,000. 48 or 58, around there. So the church have decided to do half of the budget tutapeana. Lakini I'm now appealing to my friends and voice of Vara friends to put together 28,000 to find your event, your function, your ministration. Perfect. Your ministration ikuwe na effect that it's desired in the name of Jesus. Bwana asifiwe sana. So we are looking for 28,000 or 30,000 there, and it is me and you, my friends, and the friends of Voice of Vala. Bwana asifiwe sana. So if you're going to contribute or support that ministration, like me, you're going to see me immediately after the department and tell me if it is if you are sponsoring everything, if you are sponsoring 50%, if you are sponsoring 5,000, or if you are sponsoring 2,000 ndio itakuwa ya mwisho kabisa. Bwana asifiwe sana. So 2,000 kwenda juu, utaniona ama uone Eldamigu. Eldamigu yako wapi? Eldamigu yakuja hapa. Wengine hawakujui, ndio muende mtafute. Bwana asifiwe sana. So you will see him if your heart is stirred and passionate to support that ministration, and he's going to receive that support. Or you can see me and God will bless you immensely. Chapia bwana makofi kwa sababu hizo pesa ni pesa chache sana. Bwana asifiwe sana. So kama mnatoa kutoa 2,000 mnakutana mnachanganya nyinyi wenyewe watu kama watatu wanne wale mna alafu mna present mmoja ndio analeta hiyo 2,000. Sisemi ati mtu asichangie hata kidogo. I'm just saying kwa sababu ya kufupisha traffic watu wanaweza ungana watatu wanne watoe hiyo 2,000 wapeane. Bwana asifiwe sana. Lakini in the end zikibaki msijali sasa tutawafungulia account. Naona vile wametukuta mara mingi last year. Wanasema ni season 2. Kwa hivyo kulikuwa na season 1. So we'll open for them an account. This is a ministration that we want to support as a church. It is a ministration of the voice of youth. And they are going to demonstrate what God has put in them. We want to see it so that we may also be blessed. So that we may also be able to open our eyes and see where God wants us to go. Because when the Holy Spirit comes upon the youth, what are they going to do? Young men, young women, what is happening? What is going to happen? They are going to see visions. So these people have seen visions. We must accept to see those visions and hear those visions so that we may remain aligned. Because if we do not look at those visions, the Bible says, where there is no vision, people perish. Where there is no vision, people perish. So you can see why that generation must be reasoned. Because if you don't listen, you do what? Perish. These things are very biblical. It is in the Bible, everything. It is there, black and white. Ni sasa usome ukubali ama ufanye nini? Uishi na ndoto tu, alafu uone pahali ndoto zinafi. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. God is good and all the time. Amen. Now I want the praise and worship team to come here. I can see have a very short time, but we must sing this song that says, Nimeokoka na furahi katika jina la Yesu. As we attend to that ministration of the knowledge of salvation and the remission of sin in the name of Jesus. Na hiyo wimbo iimbwe ni kama ni watu wameokoka. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kama ni watu wamefanya nini? Wameokoka. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Bwana asifiwe. Nani ameokoka hapa? Wale wote wameokoka tuseme amen. Wale wote ambao wamekombolewa tuseme a bigger amen. Wale ambao wameamua kutumikia Mungu tuseme the biggest amen. Glory to God. Najua na by time ndio tupate lyrics. Kuna mahali huwa naenda napiga push hivyo, lakini tutaimba. Sisi wote tunaimba. Amen in Jesus' name. Ah, let's go. Makofi tu kwa Yesu.
Ameniweka huru kweli. Naimba sasa hallelujah. Kwa msalaba nimepata kutoka katika utumwa. Ameniweka huru kweli. Naimba sasa hallelujah. Kwa msalaba nimepata kutoka katika utumwa. Nimeokoka na furahi. Na dhambi zangu zimetoka. Nataka kumtumikia Mwokozi wangu siku zote. Nimeokoka na furahi. Na dhambi zangu zimetoka. Nataka kumtumikia Mwokozi wangu siku zote.
Haya, tumeokoka, tumefurahi.
Zamani nilifungwa sana na minyororo ya shetani. Nikamwendea Bwana Yesu akaniweka huru kweli. Zamani nilifungwa sana na minyororo ya shetani. Nikamwendea Bwana Yesu akaniweka huru kweli.
Nimeokoka.
Nimeokoka na furahi.
Na dhambi zangu
zimetoka.
Nataka
kumtumikia Mwokozi wangu siku zote.
Nimeokoka.
Nimeokoka na furahi.
Na dhambi
zangu zimetoka.
Nataka mikono juu kwa Yesu. Sisi tunafurahia maana Dhambi zetu zimeondolewa. Ni kwa neema. Neema,
neema kubwa nilipata. Kuacha njia ya mauti. Na nguvu ya wokovu. Yanichukua siku zote.
Siku moja.
Na siku moja nitafika mbinguni kwake Mungu wangu. Milele nitamhimidi na kumlilia kwa shukrani.
Siku moja.
Na siku moja nitafika
mbinguni kwake
Mungu wangu.
Milele yote
milele itakuhimidi
na kumwimbia nimeokoka
na furaha
na dhambi zangu
nimetoka.
Nataka
kutumikia
siku zote
wakati wangu siku zote.
Nimeokoka
na furaha
na dhambi zangu
nimetoka.
Nataka
kutumikia
siku zote
wakati wangu siku zote.
Nimeokoka
na furaha
na dhambi zangu
nimetoka.
Nataka
kutumikia wakati wangu siku zote.
Amen. One more. Amen. Nitasimama kwenye mnara nione lile atakalo nitenda.
Nitasimama kwenye mnara
nione
lile atakalo nitenda.
Nitasimama
kwenye mnara
nione lile
atakalo nitenda.
Amen. Hallelujah. We can sing that for two times with the permission of my reverend in Jesus' name. Let's write it. Before we finish 2024, tutakuwa tunasimama tu tuone yale Bwana atafanya. Nitasimama kwenye mnara nione lile atakalo litenda. Nitasimama kwenye mnara nione lile atakalo. Nitasimama
kwenye
mnara
nione lile.
Nitasimama
kwenye mnara
nione lile. Waumini, nitasimama
Nione lile.
Nitasimama
kwenye mnara
nione lile.
Bwana nitasima haya nione lile nitasima tasima nione lile haya haya nitasima nione lile nione lile
Father, in the name of Jesus, we approach thy throne of mercy. Once again, we are saying, we are standing. We are standing, dear Lord of glory, to see what you're going to do to us, Lord. We worship you, my Father, because we have come. We have come by your strength. We have come by your stirring. We have come by your driving. We have come because you have made us come, O Lord. No one comes to you except they are drawn of you. For this reason, my Father, we bow in your presence and say, Holy Master, open our hearts, open the ears of our hearts, open the understanding of our mind, that God may receive from you with power and authority what, dear Father, you have desired that we may receive. That we may confess, that we may get saved, that we may get healed, that we may get redeemed, that we may get delivered in this hour, dear Master of Glory, this very hour of your visitation. We worship you, magnify you, that thy Holy Spirit continue to reign in us as we experience your heavy presence. In the name of Jesus, we continue to wait on you, looking and seeing what you're going to do to us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you all. God bless you as you pass on. In the name of Jesus. Tuwacha pia makofi mazuri. Makofi mazuri. Better than that, in the name of Jesus. And having our seats in Jesus' name. We have been reminding ourselves about the knowledge of salvation. We've been reminding ourselves about the works, the outcome of salvation, which is the remission of sin. And I believe today we will find that it will be necessary that even those whom have been and thought they are riding on the salvation of their mother, salvation of their friend, salvation of their sister or brother or uncle, they'll find that it is necessary to acquire the knowledge, this very knowledge of salvation, because in it there is a lot of wealth. A lot of wealth and power for deliverance, power for release from captivity, power to light our world, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to go very carefully to what God has put in my heart, heavily so, because I know it's very common to talk about salvation. I'm saved, I'm born again, all that. But the Spirit of the Lord is interested that today, when this grace of salvation is upon us, we deepen ourselves in the understanding of this knowledge in the name of Jesus. And that God may do to us what he intends we may understand in Jesus' name. And without maybe going round and round, you can just put your topic as coming to the knowledge of salvation. Coming to the knowledge of salvation. Coming to the knowledge of salvation. And I want to start very quickly by looking at Luke 1:77. As we understand this, we look at 77 and we look at 77, 78, and 79. And what is it that we are talking about? Why Jesus came? Why do we have God releasing his son to us? And he's saying expressly in a simple way to give knowledge of salvation to his people by the remission of their sins. What does that mean? Maybe if I repeat again, that why is Jesus sent? Why is he come for us? And I tell us it is to give knowledge of salvation to his people by the remission of their sin. If you've gone to school up to class 4, you'll understand that when you say by, it means with. So it is the example. It is making salvation experiential. Semi-experiential. It is making salvation experiential. That you are not told by many words or many descriptions, but you are made to feel, to get the experience. And then when you get the experience, you understand salvation. Bwana asifiwe sana. Uki experience, una understand salvation. So I can tell us today, unless you have experienced salvation, you have experienced the voice of salvation, then you can never come to that knowledge. Because Jesus came that we may go through the experience of remission of sin so that we may understand salvation. And when I say it's experiential, sometimes I do, and that is my methodology of training anyway, training people, teaching people to get to do things they can never imagine they can do in their lives. By the way, that is my expertise. Making people learn to do things they can never imagine they can do them in their lives. And I think that's why God called me here, so that I may be able to espouse this, that people will understand salvation by experiencing it. For example, going back to what I'm talking about, experiential, if you want to teach somebody determination, ama unataka kufundisha mtu courage, how to be courageous, how would you teach that person being courageous? How would you teach them? So you teach them by getting them through an experience that will put in them courage. An experience that will put in them courage. I know there is one or two people here who have gone through some of my training. And how do I do that? If I know you fear water, for example. If you fear water, then I take you and I dip you inside water. And I make sure you don't come out. That is experiential. You realize surely being underwater really for this time does not kill anybody. So next time I dip you the second time, that time you get courage and you take away the water phobia. Bwana asifiwe sana. So you can ufie uniogope sana upitake mbali. If you fear marriage, then I can get you, put you in marriage, and then you realize. Because there is what we call fear of marriage, gamophobia. And that's why everybody here will get married anyway. Because you have no choice anyway. Because you are with me and the Lord has deposited me here. So if you fear hate, what do I do? If you come to my school, I have a tower which was 30 meters high. 30 meters high. So what do? I take you. You fear hate very much. You cannot jump from the stool, kwenda chini. Yes, 30 meters, I put you up. You ni kama orofa kumi, I put you up. Then what do? I throw you down. When I throw you down, then you find Allah, I did not die. Then you wonder, then why? Then I take you again, I throw you again. Then after the fourth time, you are jumping saying, hey, hallelujah. That is called experiential training. So through Jesus taking us through the remission, it means we have experienced darkness, we have experienced captivity. People have experienced all manner of wickedness that binds them. But when salvation comes, you are released from that captivity. You are released from that darkness. And then you find the power of salvation. Now you can say, I am saved. And the joy of the Lord is my strength. And the Lord God is my salvation. Bwana asifiwe sana. The Lord God is my salvation. And in that manner, you become a strong warrior who will face even the fire and still say Jesus is Lord. Let us look at verses 79. We also see that he also, to give light to those who sit in darkness and the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. In the name of Jesus. One has faced Hannah. There are people who remain intimidated and they do not know whether they know. One has faced Hannah. They don't know whether they know. But when Jesus, when salvation comes, then they find, they understand, surely I was in darkness. Though there was every light, the sunlight, the electricity light, there was every manner of light. But if you start telling somebody, oh, when you get salvation, you see, you're able to see light, they are like asking you very many questions. But when salvation comes in their life through the way Jesus put it to us, then they understand. Surely I was bound. Surely I am now set free. Surely now I see the light. Because it is personal. It is something you have experienced in the name of Jesus. So this is what is coming to the knowledge of salvation. And until you have seen the light, and the light that I'm talking about, then you had better know you are not yet in salvation. Until you have been disconnected from every form of captivity, that people can intimidate you and you feel sad. People can mess you up and you feel broken. People can cause you to get into depression. If you can be caused to go to depression, that is a form of captivity. And that means you have not experienced the salvation of the Lord. The Lord God is still not your salvation. So if you are going to rejoice in the Lord God of your salvation, you must experience the salvation. Experientially, you must experience it in the name of Jesus. That is now coming to the knowledge of salvation. Am I walking with somebody? Am I walking with you? Yes. So if you have, and you can be, or you are a candidate of depression, know there is salvation of the Lord in which you can be redeemed and not suffer depression because of these people, issues, or anything, in the name of Jesus. There are people who are there and they're feeling they are sick in their body. Not the sickness that you know, not the sickness that you can see, but they feel in their mind, in their life, as that they do not belong. And this is the work of the devil, to hold us captive. We can experience the salvation of the Lord by coming out of that in the name of Jesus. Such that when we even suffer, and I thank God for today's lesson. It is wonderful. Those who missed today's pure word, we might have to do an intercessory prayer for you. Because for you to walk this journey, you need a lot of depth in Jesus' name. And why do we need to have this knowledge? Number one is the knowledge of God and salvation keeps believers steadfast. It keeps believers steadfast through persecution and suffering. Hallelujah. Getting to know, to have this knowledge, it keeps you free. It keeps you steadfast. Though the suffering or the persecution is happening, it makes you, or you remain strong and standing because you have the knowledge of salvation. And this cannot be demonstrated as better than what happened this morning. And I was so shocked. I told my group, this is the best scripture I have come across this year. And I said, sure, God and the Holy Spirit is with us because he's espousing us to getting us the spiritual experience of salvation. Let us look at 1 Peter 4, verses 12, verses 13. Verses 12, 1 Peter chapter 4, First Peter chapter 4, verses 12. First Peter chapter 4, verses 12. So, beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trials which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. Verses 13. But rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's suffering, that when his glory is revealed, you may also be glad with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. But rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's suffering, that when his glory is revealed, you may also be glad with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. Let us jump to verse 16 so that as I discuss this, we are already clear about where you're going, where you're coming from. Yet, if anyone suffers as a Christian, are you a Christian? Hallelujah. Are you a Christian? Amen. Do you suffer? Have you ever suffered? And how many asked, where is God? And the way I've served you, God, the way I praise, the way I pray, the way I offer, the way I give. How many ask those questions? So we are being told, let him not be ashamed. Yeah? People are to how, what would I tell people? People know that I'm saved. Now I'm going through this. They are saying, they are thinking maybe, or you're thinking, where is God? Why has he left me? But let him glorify God in this matter. Let him glorify God in this matter. So when you look at these portions, and you are talking about having experiential knowledge of salvation, it means that you will come to full understanding that salvation is both current and coming. So there is a hope and there is a current situation. And we are saying that the salvation, when we have seen here, tumeona wokovu unani utanibeba, hiyo wimbo unakumbuka, the salvation will carry you, bwana asifiwe sana, it will make you free. So when you look at this, the Bible has started by saying that those, when these things happen to us, we should not look at them as strange. Let us look at 12, verses 12. Go back to verses 12. Beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange things have happened to you. Sometimes I know all of us, you lack money, maybe even for your rent. You lack money even for school fees. You lack money. And you think that's a very serious problem. We're being told these are fiery trials, which is to try you. Which is to try you. As though you don't look at it as though it's a strange thing. Sometimes you get sick and you're on your hospital bed and brethren have come to see you and they have visited you and they have prayed for you. And then nothing is feeling like it's happening. Do not think it is a strange thing happening. Sometimes you are there and you are like, we needed a child at this time. And you are like, God is not hearing, really? And like, it is not happening. And you find that pressure. Like everyone, oh, let us pray. Oh, we have been praying for you. Oh, we have been. And then we are being told, if you understand and come to the knowledge of salvation, you will know it is not a strange thing happening. It is not a strange thing that is happening. When you understand and you come to the knowledge of salvation, you will know there is an issue of glorifying God. An issue of glorifying God. Let us look at 13 again so that you understand better. But rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's suffering. I'm putting this Christ suffering, I will explain kidogo, that when his glory is revealed, you may also be grand with exceeding joy. I want to put it to you that the salvation of the Lord is present and present, present continuous. Na future continuous. Kuna future tense na continuous. Nisaidiwa na walimu wa Kiingereza. So it is here now. It is going to go with you. It is going to be with you. It is going to take you to internal hope, to internal glory. And that is how salvation is. It is a process of carrying you through. Those who I discussed with, I don't know whether it was Monday, and we agreed it is a process. And we agreed that that process has levels of the sanctification, consecration, and that. It takes you through. And I tell you, when the Lord is the Lord of your salvation, then there is nothing that happens in your life that is not known of God. Tumepatana, not known of God. Yes, I am sick. Yes, God knew. There's no money in the house. Yes, God knew. There's conflict. Tunakosana na bwana yangu sana. There's conflict. There's a challenge. Yes, God knew. Because God is not overtaken by situation. But we are going through this because we must be tried. You all know, for you to be promoted anywhere, for you to get a better level, you must be tried, you must be examined, and when you have been examined, you go to the next level. You have waited so much for this which you thought you really deserve. God knows that. And this is happening so that in the end, God may be glorified. And when that glory is revealed, hallelujah, when that glory is revealed, then you are like, my. You mean this is what was come out of it? When the resurrection of Jesus happened and he was seen and they were told Jesus is risen, they ran and they saw for sure he is risen. It was such a mighty glory. When they were looking at him as he was ascending, it was huge. It was such a glory. When that glory is revealed, you become exceedingly excited. You become exceedingly happy. So the issue here is to understand your God of your salvation, the Lord God of your salvation. And when you understand that, that which you understand through the way you have been delivered from your sin, you've been delivered from your illnesses, you've been delivered from all the challenges. Because what happens is that trial comes for a time. And that time is a time that is measured, which can be, when I say sana, it is so deep and so powerful that I am not finding proper words, but the Holy Spirit will help me. But let me ask you, one day when Job was doing very well in the land, we got a message here by Pastor Jane on how he used to pray for his children every day. Pray for his children every day. That nothing should go wrong about their lives. Tumepatana, imagine every day an offering a sacrifice. None of us does that. None of us does that. And our children have not died. And if they have died, it is fine. Because there is a reason why they have died. Because God does everything with a reason. So, Satan appears before God like other sons of men and sons of God. So I'm making a revelation to you. When God is in his place, he sees everyone and he can get in touch with everyone. He can talk with everyone, even Satan. So he sometimes salimiaga shetani. How are you, Satan? Maisha inaendeleaje huko? Then Satan anasema, pana pambana. Hapa sioni ukipata kamutu. Wao vile nimewawahi. Sioni ukipata hini. So God anamwambia, okay, sawa. Ngana tu. Tutaona how far you'll go. So that day, it was like this. Hi, Satan, habari? Mzuri sana. Now, umetoka wapi by the way leo? Nimetoka na huko kumanga manga tu kidogo kidogo nikiangalia majamaa wa kuconvince, lakini anyway niko tu naendelea. In your process ya kumanga manga, have you seen one man, mtu mmoja mkali sana wangu ambaye ako upright, blameless, na huyo mtu pia ana fear God sana, ananifia sana, mambo yote kabla afanye lazima anikonso huyo mmoona. Akasema ule jamaa Job Ule wa ile pale Kasarani. Ah, huyo namjua sana. Huyo namuelewa vizuri sana. Huyo mtu ni vile umemtajirisha, umemprotect, umemvika utukufu, mambo yake yote kwa sawa. Kwa nini asikuogope? Hata mimi kama ningekuwa in that situation ningekufanya nini? Ambeo basi sawa. Take away kila kitu. Lakini roho yake ubaki, ubakisha. Because hiyo ndio itatuambia finally kama so kumbuka hiyo biashara inaendelea na Mungu na Shetani. Job ako na issue. Saa hiyo biashara yake inapanda. Kama ni za mgoro carpet zinanunuliwa, kama ni gakere watu wamejaa mat. Mat imejaa watu wanaanza kama Eva, si ndio? Si ndio? Bwana asifiwe sana. Wale wako kwa kazi, things are looking good. Everyone is happy. Things are going nicely. Even that morning Job had prayed for his children. Na akajua actually in the afternoon watakuwa party. They will be enjoying themselves. So have asked to intercede for them. Do you know what happens? Then Satan, unajua akisha pata ruhusa hapotezi na wakati. So akaambiwa toa hizo vitu zote, akakimbia tua, akakuja. At that time walikuwa wako na party, kuna vitu wengine wanarisha, kondoo zinarishwa kila kitu. So he started blow after blow, kondoo zote zimeenda, ngamia zote zimeenda. And finally the message that comes to Job is that hata watoto wote wamefanya nini, walikuwa kwa party, upepo ikakuja ikafanya nini, kabomoa kila kitu na wakaweza kuisha. Sijui kama walichomeka pia. But that is the message that is coming to Job. So what am I telling us with this story that is real and biblical? That there is nothing that happens in your life that God does not know. It may look so awkward and awful, but God is aware. Because one, either he allowed it or he caused it to happen. That is our God. Why? It is a fiery trial. A fiery trial. And that fiery trial can only be happening in God's view knowledge. So when you understand the salvation of God, then you understand when you are through that fiery trial that God is aware. And then you'll jump to what Paul said through the Spirit of God, that all things work out for good to those who love God and are called according to his purposes. When you are in that knowledge and that understanding, you will say like Job and say, though you tear me into pieces and slay me, and I find that it's only my soul and my mouth that can talk, then I'll still praise you, I'll still exalt you, I'll still honor you, I'll still glorify you in the name of Jesus. And in that manner, that is when this glory is manifested. So when you are in that understanding, because we have spiritual babies, and this is why God wants us to understand this message, that salvation means you will be able to be steadfast through persecution, through trials, through suffering, knowing very well that the Lord God of your salvation is going to redeem you. And in the end, all the sufferings and all the persecutions will be a past tense. What you'll be remaining with is a testimony, glory, and thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. The Bible says many are the tribulations of the righteous, but God delivers from them all. So you must be in this understanding, people of God, Christ sent, because you must be hard, steadfast, firm, and strong, that you do not find pity on yourself because this thing is happening, and therefore they will think, I am not a good believer, or why is this happening, God? Why me? You know, many times we say, why me? Then I'm going to wonder, whom did you want? Unataka nani akuwe kwa hiyo story? Unataka ulikuwa nani akuwe kwa hiyo ngori, nina? Ulitaka nani ya kwe kwa hiyo ngori? Kasi wewe. So, sahihu kwa hiyo ngori, because it's a fire trial that God won't take you through, so that when he gets you out of it, you will have a mouth to glorify his name. If you are wise, Bwana asifiwe sana. If you understand and if you are wise, if you are in the knowledge of salvation, Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. So it is important that we understand salvation through experience, what God has done. There are so many things he has done in our lives. And of course we forget one time after another. Kuna time ulikuwa in a certain serious ngori. God delivered you from it. And you thought it was a bahati. Ukafikiria ni kuescape kwa mnyaka ama bahati. You are in another one. But all those are trials. And when you manage them well, like somebody who has an understanding of salvation, then you build the glory of God in your life, and you also grow the experience of salvation in Jesus' name. Number two, understanding of the salvation cause, it causes the believer to proclaim the gospel of God in the world. When you understand that salvation, you know the sweetness, you know the hope it gives you. You know, salvation gives us very serious hope. It is not like the hope that is seen by men. It is not what people can feel. It is not what people can trust. You know, this is God, and it's different from what arrangement people can make. When you understand it in that manner, then you cannot shut your mouth. You cannot be silent. You cannot be silent. You will proclaim the goodness and the gospel of the Lord in the world in Jesus' name, so that you may be in tandem with the purposes of God. You'll be in tandem with the purpose of Jesus. That's why he said in Luke 4:43, if we might mind to Luke 4:43, in the name of Jesus, 4:43. I know sometimes this zinapitia kwa mawazo unasema sasa hata kuanguka mtihani na nilianguka sasa siwezi repeat. Unajua ukipata D minus, ni D minus ama ni E? Mtu anaweza repeat? Mtu anaweza repeat akiwa na D minus? Anaweza repeat from two. Sindio? You know, sometimes when you see and understand the salvation and see what God delivered us from and how you can wait on the Lord, like what Elizabeth told us, you wait upon the Lord. You know, there is a testimony in this church where one of our daughters, alipofanya mtihani, akapata, is it? Alipata B ama C plus? If I'm reminded. Ilikuwa C plus ama D, ama B. Bwana asifiwe sana. Ilipata C. And then, this daughter of ours wanted to be in the medical. And you see, now you cannot be a doctor when you have a... And this daughter says, My Redeemer, Reveth. You know what she says? I'm going to form three. See, you require form four. Naenda form three. Is she working in the hospital now or not? This is miracle, something that has happened, confirmed, and working. You know, you might look, oh, same as you, yes. Miaka ni yako, ama ni ya Mungu. Miaka ni ya nani? You are struggling with years, counting forward, backward. What can you add on your years? Nothing. You can do nothing. Some people can get rich very fast. And then when they get rich very fast, we always say, when you are very fast, you nafika mapema. Kwani kuna safari ile ukienda haraka sana. Zinazima ufika mapema. Kwani ukikuwa mrefu haraka, utaendelea kurefuka ama utafika pahali pa mwisho urefu sama. Does not matter how fast you have grown tall. Where tu? But will you continue? Tafika pali usima? So when you come to and can do about my life, hope it will put in me, then I can be able to walk and proclaim these others. So when you understand and you are in the full knowledge of salvation, then you will wake up and you will find that you have something so precious, you cannot let your mother not understand. You cannot let your brother not understand. You cannot let your sister not know. You cannot let your friend not know. Because you have something. And that, in so doing, you will be sharing in the goodness of God to those who are desperate and in need. And they will see the Lord of our salvation. They will understand the goodness of this salvation. I'm talking about this salvation in reality terms. That's why I talked about experiential. Because many times we talk about being saved, salvation, and then even those who are saved, quote, they do not understand. Mtu mengia kwa kashida kadogo tu, kashida kadogo tu. And ndiyo uyo, minogonoko, minogono, miyana noona, piti pate. Ha? Mbaka nao, anaanza kubrimu watu. Oh, hata nilikuwa mgonjwa. Hakuna mtu alikuja kuniona. Kumbe, that was the test. The test was, will you look unto God or will you look unto people? Ukaanguka tu ile A. Unajua kuna exam kuna kuwa number 1 A na number 1 B. So number 1 A ni kuamba, do you trust in God or do you fear God? Number 1 A, sister so and so, brother so and so, pastor, imagine, nikarara hosi, mbaka nikatoka, na mbaka nikaenda home, jihati pastor anauliza kaa nishapona. Iyo A, unaanguka. Because all your mind, all your eyes, all your hope was in the pastor. Haya, kuna kuwaga na B, B part sasa. B part ni ya endurance. A ni ya ku, where, whom do you trust? B, endurance. So how much, how patiently, how enduring was you? So wengine, hata hiyo B anaanguka. Because hii B anasema, hiyo kanisa, wakiniona tena, wakikui wanasemaga, aniite nganga. Hiyo kanisa akiniona tena aniite nani? For sure, anajipanga na kuna kule ame hope. Sasa, but B pia anafanya nini? Naanguka. Endurance, haijapatikana. So what I'm telling us, we must be conscious and understand and have the knowledge of salvation and be able to be activated in that like manner. Number 3, we should not reject this knowledge. When we know it, we will know it is important. We will not reject it. Number 4, to know Christ the Messiah, the baptism in which that we have been called into. This is the power that brings us to the ultimate redemption. You know that power. You say when you know the gospel of God is gospel unto salvation, is the power of God unto salvation, is the power of God unto total redemption. When you understand it, you know you are in the real and the presence and the path, the way of total redemption in the name of Jesus. Because of time, I want to make faster progress by telling us number 5, this knowledge prepares men with repentance in order to receive the coming of the Lord Jesus. This knowledge prepares men with repentance in order to receive the coming of the Lord. Bwana asifiwe sana. Friends, let me tell us, in as much as we are saved and the level that we are, we say it is a process. There is level 1, 2, 3, mpaka mwisho. And we say the mwisho level is holiness, the righteousness of God. When you have attained the righteousness of God. Hapo sasa, ndio uko katika utayari kamili wa kupokea ufalme wa Mungu. Because you must be in a position where you can receive the kingdom of God. So in that level, in this position, you are prepared to receive the kingdom of God. And how do you get there? By ensuring that your repentance is part of your every word that is uttered. That is preparing you with repentance. You are prepared with repentance. Because surely, very soon something is happening. And we must be aware, whether we'll be dead or alive, we must be ready for that particular day. Because one of these days, when we have gone with the matatus, when we have ridden with the prados that you so much desire, when you have lived in that mansionette that you have so much desired, when you have really gotten married, the much really wanted to do, when you have gotten all the money that you thought that you're going to get, when you have done all that, and sometimes not having it all anyway, we are going to find the day of the Lord with us. The day of the Lord with us. It is surely coming. Because our day of salvation is nearer than the day we first believed. Every day that we move, it happens. Let us look at 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 10. 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 10. In the name of Jesus. But the day of the Lord will come. The day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt. With fervent heat, both the earth and the works that are in it will be burnt up. The earth and the works that are in it will be burnt up. Heavens that you see will disappear. The earth, those who talk the language of the other side, we are being told it will be folded like a letter. Folded like a letter. We are told that all the things you have looked and envied, maybe you have ever said, if I get that kind of flat, if I really have maybe a jet or maybe I have a flight, anything you've desired, all the works that are in it will be burnt up. They will disappear. They'll vanish. Let us look at verses 11. Therefore, since all these things will be dissolved, what manner of person ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness? What kind of person are you supposed to be as regard to conduct and godliness? Whether we want it or not, a day will come when your children will be the children of God. Your husband will be the husband or be just a man of God in heaven. Your wife will be just a woman of God in heaven. And everything is there. You are left with your soul to worship God all the days of your life, to glorify Him and to behold the beauty thereof. That is the day that is coming. Anybody who is bright enough, wise enough, will know that they are in pilgrimage. They are in a pilgrim. They are sojourners. They are just passers by. Bwana asifiwe sana. However your days may be, hata zikiwa nyingi kama 120 years, zikiwa nyingi kama 130 years, whatever you eat, ukule octopus, ukule dedema, ukule ngwashi, ujinyime shukari, kila ufanye zote. A day is coming. Bwana asifiwe sana. Mimi sisemi ati usijime sukari. Kama unaona, utaishi. Nijime tu, no problem. But one thing is true. One day is coming that we shall be also out of this earth. And the day of the Lord is coming. With all the works, zile vitu zote, those accounts, those monies that you have always very much desired. This is now coming to the knowledge of salvation. When all these come and they are winded up, then you shall now look and see whether you are counting losses or you are counting profit. I'm not telling you not to work hard. I'm not telling you not to get anything. But I want you to be in the knowledge that even as you get these things, even as you get married, even as you get empires of businesses, even as anything is happening in your life, be in one great understanding that all and the works therein are gonna be dissolved. That's the ultimate thing. They're gonna be dissolved. So when they are dissolved, and having this knowledge, what manner of man ought you be? That's why I am saying this knowledge of salvation prepares you to receive the day of the Lord in the right manner and in right standing in the name of Jesus. So when you are in this understanding, you shall be able to bless the Lord your God. And you will be in a position to proclaim Philippians 3:7 in the name of Jesus. You'll be in a position to proclaim Philippians 3:7 in the name of Jesus. I'm telling us this so that we may not anchor things in our lives and misappropriate our priorities. On Tuesday, I was in a situation whereby you could not call the president, you could not call the CS, you could not call the police commissioner, you could not call anybody in this land aweze kukusaidia, because everybody was learning for their dear life. Bwana asifiwe sana. Everybody was learning for their dear life. You thought your MP is very powerful. Alikuwa analia akikuruma, akikuruma, akiangalia nyuma, akisikiza sauti. In the meeting that I was, mothers were calling their children and they were not answering phones. And when they did not answer, they threw the phone down and they started wailing. They started crying. Big people, senior people, serious people. Then I told them, let us finish this meeting. Let us pray. At least I had somewhere to call. At least I had somewhere to make a call. When all calls could not work. And I told Jehovah, take care of this situation. Those are bullets. They are running. It is sure they are running over. But preserve our lives in the name of Jesus. And preserve the life of people. Let us not hear the clearing and deaths of thousands and hundreds because you are Jehovah. Bonus Fesana. So when you know that, you will know how to live because you have the knowledge of the Lord of your salvation. Philippians 3:7, the Bible says, but what things were gained to me, these I have counted loss for Christ. Bonus Fesana. The things that were gained to me, I counted loss for Christ. In Jesus' name. And let us look at 8. The Bible says that yet indeed I also count all things loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nimekubali kutupa yote. Naam, zaidi ya hayo na hesabu mambo yote kuwa hasara kwa ajili ya uzuri usio na kiasi wa kumjua Kristo Bwana wangu ambaye kwa ajili yake nimepata hasara ya mambo yote nikihesabu kuwa kama Reverend anakubaliwa kusoma hiyo imeandikwa kwa Biblia kama mavi ili nipate Kristo. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nani amekubali kukuja na mavi leo chache? Na kwa nyumba kuna pahali tunaweza tukute umeweka. Unahesabu kuwa kama? You know, by the time Paul is saying this, alikuwa amejaribu kufundisha watu kama vile ninajaribu kueleza, akaona hawaelewi. Akasema ikuwe kama mavi. Kama mavi, ikuwe kama rubbish. And you know, there is a lot of weight in this, my dears. Because, look at sometime, you find somebody in hospital bed. Ako hata ajielewi. What hope, what other hope does that person? Watu wanaweza kuwa narukaruka nje, oh, sijui bili bado inaendelea kuongezeka, oh, bili bado. Huyu mtu ako na story na bili. Bili nishugulie. Nye ndani kurukaruka juu ya bili. But yeah, he's not there. Finally, akipason, he enters his rest. Na ndio maana unasikia tukisema amepumzika. Munaweza hanga muweka WhatsApp, biri mchange, mruke juu mwende chini mwende wapi? Hiyo ni shughuli ni eh? Ukienda umpate pale ame relax tu. Bwana asifiwe sana. When we come to the knowledge of salvation, then we'll understand how to put everything in its place and we'll declare just like this. Indeed, I count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge. That knowledge alone is important to you than anything else because it makes you live in another way. And that's what we call circumspective. Maisha ambayo yameadirika, ambayo yamekaa ya kujielewa. You know, sometimes you think that when you become this, you'll be okay. You'll be able to build a house, work a fence, work a tiki fence, work a soldier engine, a soldier ndani. Asifuwe sana. Go and ask your friends. Your fence, na soldier engine, na soldier ndani, na CCTV, inasaidia na nini. They will tell you, my brother, be at peace with every man. Because that way you are safe. You are safe. So, this hour and this day, I want to tell us, there's nothing you can exchange with the knowledge of Christ your Lord. Nothing. From where I stand, nothing. From where I stand, nothing. So you had better pursue this knowledge, its excellence, and its works. nimesema na kazi za hiyo elimu, huo ujuzi wa kumjua Kristo ndani yake. Na kazi yake ni nini? Ni kutufanya tubadilike. That work of that knowledge is to change us, to transform us completely, to move from that state to another new state. Like we will confirm with 2 Corinthians 5:17. That when you have this knowledge, na umeyelewa vizuri kama leo, vile umeyelewa, wewe utainuka na useme, nimekata kauli, haijalishi. I will make a decision that this knowledge of salvation shall be a constant reminder in my heart. Itakaa katika moyo wangu. This knowledge will stay in me with power to make me be able to make the necessary adjustments. Kila wakati ukisikia umekosa promotion, una revert. Knowledge of salvation. Unajua tu, promotion does not come from the east or the west. It comes from the Lord God of my salvation. Bwana asifiwe sana. Then you know, kama haijapatikana, then the one that is right is coming. Bwana asifiwe sana. And for this reason, I exalt God, I promote and I glorify God. And when you glorify God like that, like Satan having done that bad work on Job, God looked at Job and found that the man has remained steadfast in persecution, in pain, and then he stretched his hand. Akampatia warembo, watoto maridadi warembo kuliko wale wakwa, wakwanza. Akamultiply everything, gamia marambili, ngombe marambili, wafanyikazi marambili, everything twice. Bwana asifiwe sana. When it comes from the Lord God of your salvation, it will come full measure. It will be in the fullness of time, beautiful. Bwana asifiwe sana. Beautiful. And it shall be pleasing before the eyes of the Lord. When you understand and appreciate the excellence of that knowledge of your salvation. But what have you to do? You have to change. You have to transform. 2 Corinthians 5:17. The Bible says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old things have gone, have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. You are understanding new. You are talking new. Your habits new. Your lifestyle new. How you do things new. You do not remain in the old, because you are in full knowledge of Christ. And this is what I would call spiritual revolution. Bwana asifiwe sana. Spiritual revolution. That in you something has happened. It has transformed you completely. Now you do not use the benchmark that the world uses. It is difficult, I know. I appreciate. Nakubaliana nawe kabisa. Ni ngumu ku benchmark. Kusema sina job lakini nagojea Mungu. It is hard, isn't it? It is hard. This business inachomeka lakini nagojea mu. My husband amefutwa kazi lakini nagojea mu. It is difficult. But it has to be difficult anyway, because that is the nature of the trial. I said the question has number one A, number one B. So find yourself, number one A, how have I rated? And what about B? And so you know there is also a C. How have I rated? But then this can only happen when you are completely transformed, when you are completely changed, when you are completely clear and you have no sins, you are completely out of darkness, out of slavery, out of all manner of thinking that would put you in that situation. As I continue to proceed to conclude, because today I want us to get saved. Because you could be saying you are saved, but I think you are not. Some of us, many of us are not saved. So I think today is the day of salvation. This is the day that the grace of salvation shall work in our lives. And we shall receive Christ in a way that now we understand. Because some people usually come to church because they want to be protected. Kuja kanisa ndio akuwe mtu mzuri ndio asione shida. Akuja kanisa akuwe mtu mzuri asipate shida. Asipate shida. Nani alikuja kanisa asipate shida? Yes, of course after preaching that way no hand will rise up. But I know many watu wengi unaenda kanisa ndio wasipate shida. The beauty of the shida you will get when you are before God is it has come, it is in the knowledge of your Father. He knows it, and therefore his redemption measures, mitigation measures, they go in place, and they are sweet because when you experience them, you will be able to appreciate. So I want to say that when we have been called to this goodness, then we understand that we are in a level of a people that are privileged, a people that have come from darkness, a people that have come from captivity, and are now in a kingdom. This is where I wanted us to end. We have come in a kingdom, and this kingdom has everything. But however, the partakers of this kingdom must appreciate that victory is sweet when there is one. Every victory is sweet. But if there is no victory, then there is no sweetness. And that is the joy of this kingdom. Kushinda na kushinda na kushinda na kushinda. Every team that wins, it feels good, isn't it? So watu wanapendekea shabiki ile timu wao ina win. Lakini can it win without trials? Can it win without a game? Eh? Watu wale wanangana ni wanashindaka siku hizi ni wa Chelsea ama ni wa Man U? Sijui, me I don't know. But those who win ni wale wameshinda wamepitia games, ndio? Na wale wamekaa somewhere in a corner and they don't play any game, will they ever win? No. So if you have never been tried in the spiritual life, you can never win. Because you have never taken that trial. So take that trial with joy and satisfaction in your heart, knowing that there is an owner who is preparing for victory in Jesus' name. Then you know you have entered into a kingdom, a holy nation, you are now a royal priesthood in a land that you can declare the goodness of the Lord. As we can confirm in 1 Peter 2:9, we know that we are in a presence that is of greatness, a presence of victory in the name of Jesus. A presence where we know we are not here by choice. We are not here by fluke. It is not a coincidence. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people. His own special people. This is what it means. His own special people. So when you know you are a special people of God of this kingdom, then you know whether they put you in prison, whether they burn your house, whether they take away your children, whether they keep you like you do not matter, of no value, you know. An hour is coming when everything will be revealed, and that will be the glory of God. Chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. One as first hand. So long as you cannot see the darkness you are called from, then I can confirm to you, you have not known salvation. If you cannot see the darkness from which you are retrieved, the captivity from which you are brought, the pains from which you are brought, and brought to a marvelous light. And what does that marvelous light mean? Understanding. You understand the situation and the matters of the kingdom in the name of Jesus. That way, you will be a steadfast person that knows, as people are singing, they have their rights, that you have the rights of the kingdom. And no matter what threat will come before you, you have the rights of the kingdom because you are his own chosen people. You know you belong to God. You belong to him. So whatever happens, watu waruke chini warudi juu, watakupata hapo ukiwa una rights zako, na itabidi wakusikize katika jina la Yesu. When that goodness is in you, no pain, no threat, no curse, no destruction will take away you from the goodness of the Lord. And this is the joy of God. This is the great thing. And that's why in this sanctuary today, there is no way any one of us can escape or run away from this great salvation. Having understood this, we shall ask, how else and how therefore can we run? How therefore can we escape this great salvation? Because our time of salvation is now. And we are being told, surely, every soul shall surely die. And after death, judgment. After death, judgment. So if today you get into that other level of resting, because you have said you can rest. Resting in the body is fine, but the problem is the soul. If the soul is not of God, then the torment, the pain continues to the other side. So if this day you are asked of this body of the owner, and then you are left and you rest, would you test the eternity of goodness? Would you test the God of eternity? Would you entaste that glory? Or you will just be there and we are counting things. And everything, by the way, you'll have left behind will be of no use to you. So how, therefore, can we forfeit this great salvation? As we are being reminded by the writer of Hebrews 2, verses 3. How can we forfeit such a great salvation? Hebrews 2, verses 3. The name of Jesus. As we look at ourselves and understand and reflect at ourselves. Because if we neglect, then the die is cast. How shall we escape? How shall we escape? Even now when you are living, how will you escape? If we neglect so great a salvation, now that we have understood and seen the knowledge of Christ, of this salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed to us by those who heard him. You know, the Lord spoke about the salvation and said, for this purpose I was sent, for this purpose I'm here, so I must preach this gospel. So he first talked about it. He first preached it. Jesus preached it with his words. And then finally he went to the cross, died, and he was under for 3 days. That we now experience the deliverance. We experience the beauty of that liberation. And when we experience it, then we feel surely this is salvation experiential. We can feel it. It is personal. Now I confirm I'm a sojourner. Then we are being asked, how can we escape? You cannot escape this wrath and that judgment of God while you're walking on the land and when you have gone on the other side. It is not going to be possible. Because it has been spoken while we're here, we have walked with it, we must be able to respond in the manner that God is going to deliver us and in the manner we are going to enjoy. This message is a double-edged way. That if you are saved, we must be able at walk in that manner in which we shall continually feel that salvation by way of continuous deliverance now, continuous deliverance as we wait and as the Lord comes. But if you are not saved, then it is a message so powerfully inviting us to this grace of salvation in which we experience this freedom and live it. And have the joy that we have just described. We have the freedom, the light that we have just described. Sisi je, tutapataje kupona. Tukipuuza wokovu mkuu namna hii. Ambao kwanza ulinenwa na Bwana, kisha ukadhibitika kwetu na wale waliomsikia. Bwana asifiwe sana. You have walked among many, and you have seen people who have walked in righteousness, and you have experienced, and you are in this sanctuary because the Lord invited you for purposes of you receiving this great salvation and this great revelation, that you may be able to make a turnaround in your heart, as we have seen, from your old nature to the former nature. Some of us are just there by virtue of prayer. But we are praying without the word of God in us. It is not of any use if you pray and you have no resource of the word of God in you. So you must pray with deliverance and this experience in you. Attending church without repentance is only but heaping judgment on yourself. Because this is a matter of living a life that we must be transformed. We must be okay. It will not add any value to you. And even if you've been in persecution and tribulation, and then you know very well there is no salvation, you have not been transformed, then you'll be knowing this is not of God, neither is God allowed it. Because that's the pain. That you can be in a situation, you know, surely I'm not really saved. So whatever is happening, you are not sure. Whether it's from God or whether it's from the devil, you are not aware. But when you are completely submerged, transformed, then you know, even if it is death, this God is aware. And therefore have no cause to get worried. Because it is in line with his will. And it is good for me because I love him. And I'm called according to his purposes. But if you are not, then it is misery. That's where desperation and depression comes from. So we must be able to know that we cannot pay lip service about God and about his kingdom without life service. Our life must serve God. Our life must be in his hands, that we may be able to bless him and to glorify his name, and that we truly may be able to enjoy this salvation. It is useless and very bad to be just religious. Mimi ni wa hiyo church na kuwaga member wa hiyo church. But surely there is no action and there is no belief, there is no faith in Jesus. There is no faith in Jesus. It will not work anything for you. It will only work misery, because you'll be in total confusion when a matter happens in your life. You have no idea how to go about it. And you'll find that you'll have a lot of pain, because that understanding and that lack knowledge of knowledge is not going to be. Coming on Sunday is good enough, but it must have an outcome of adding to your life. You cannot be coming, not coming. Double-minded people. James says, you not get anything from God, because they're just like a wave that comes and seems big, but just when you think it could carry you away, it goes back. So it is time that we can rise up and be able to rededicate our life to Jesus. Those who are saved, recommit our life to Jesus. Those who are not at all tried and even tested this salvation, to call upon Jehovah and receive this salvation of God in the name of Jesus. I want us to rise up in the name of Jesus and worship Jehovah, and we may pray to God, our God of salvation, and find whether we are rejoicing in this God of salvation. Stand up on your feet as you meditate upon your soul, and as you continue to make this very important decision, because tonight, this hour, we must be able to commit our lives to God. We must be able to commit our life to Jesus. We must receive this salvation experientially. We must receive it experientially in the name of Jesus. As we continue to worship Jehovah, as the Spirit will lead us, I want to worship God because of you. And I want you to open your mouth and tell God, Father, I understand. I now want to get to the full knowledge of your salvation. I want to get to full understanding. I worship you, Jehovah. I honor you. I adore you. Surely I know I have really misunderstood for the longest of times. I have not had the true and correct understanding. Now I understand. My position will be different. I am not going to be among those who curse you, those who even say and ask, where is my God? Those who become steadfast. I will be steadfast in my persecution. I will be steadfast in my trials. I will be steadfast. Orakashandarabori magandarabashakadusi. Ekashanda. Open your mouth and call upon Jehovah in the name of Jesus, as we continue to appreciate the grace of salvation in the house, because our Lord is truly here with his love and with his kindness. He is truly here, and he is concerned that we may be transformed from this old form of ours to the new form in the name of Jesus, in which we shall glorify him. We shall glorify him in the morning. We shall glorify him in the noontime. We shall glorify him. Rekashandarabagantaramashanta. Namwendea Yesu kwa kusafiwa in the name of Jesus. Remagantaramashakadasuri. Because the Lord God is here to cleanse us and wash us completely, to be pure and holy in the name of Jesus. Rekashukaramagandaraburi. Are you there? I want you to interrogate your spirit. And if you are persuaded by the Spirit of Jehovah for your full redemption, you can even approach the throne, approach the altar of God. Our salvation is here. Nobody is gonna fear. Usiogope chochote. Wewe kuja na boldness. Ukiambia Bwana nataka kutest na kujua. Your knowledge of salvation is my portion in the name of Jesus. That I will be ready for your coming in the name of Jesus. It is for the freedom, so that we together in one faith confess that our sins are forgiven and that we receive this mighty salvation in the name of Jesus. There is no any other name in heaven or in earth, below the earth, that we must be saved. So it is important, if you are there, you do not need to fear anyone. You do not need to look at anybody. It is your mother's salvation you have been anchoring on. You have been coming and you have thought it is all well. I can tell us there is an appointment and a special appointment with every one of us to have a moment and a day when we can say, Lord, today I give my life to you. I give my life to you. I believe in thy word. And in this word, Father, I confess in the name of Jesus. So if you are there, it is your opportunity, a golden opportunity, an opportunity like none other. Yes, you are there and you have felt really that walk I have lived. It is not a walk I can give a testimony. Ni maisha ambao nimeishi siwezi kueleza vizuri. Haijulikani vema. Sielewi hata mimi vizuri kama wokovu wangu ni wa aina gani. Nafasi hii Bwana ameitoa ili tukaweza kuomba pamoja nawe. Na wewe ukaweza kupata ukombozi ambao ni huru. Ukombozi ambao utakutenga na mambo yote ambayo yanaumiza. Captivity, depression, mambo ambayo yamefanya baka akili yako ionekane kama haiko sawa. Wanakufikiria pengine hauko sawa. Lakini nakwambia Kristo anaweza badilisha sura yako, abadilisha sura ya mambo yako na kubadilisha hata moyo wako kama vile ametuambia. Tutabadilishwa na kale yetu ipite, uzamani wetu upite, tubadilike tuwe viungo tuwe viumbe vipya katika Kristo, in the name of Jesus. It is your time to present yourself in the name of Jesus, because this is your hour in the name of Jesus. You have backslidden and you cannot have confidence to walk before Jehovah. We want to remove that veil, that captivity. Tunataka tuondoe hukumu juu yako katika jina la Yesu. Manake huu ndio wakati wa wokovu. This is the day of your salvation. We cannot neglect such a great salvation in the name of Jesus. We tembea tu hapa kuja pole pole. Neema Bwana iko mahali hapa. The grace of salvation is here and we are seeing. The Lord is interested. Ni wewe tu anaweko na haja na wewe. Ndio maana ametusukuma namna hiyo ili aweze kukuhudumia katika jina la Yesu. Teka shandara buri maganta. Tumwendea Yesu kwa kusafiwa. Entara maganta. Tunasubiri na tunasema Yesu anakupenda, anakujali na njia ya ajabu, kwa sababu yeye ni mwaminifu na Mungu wa rehema. Hakuna siku nyingine, hakuna nafasi nyingine ambayo yuko special kuliko hiyo ambayo Bwana ametupatia katika jina la Yesu. Nafasi ya kupata wokovu, nafasi ya kurejeshwa katika wema wa Bwana, nafasi ya kusimama mara tena katika ukuu wake katika jina la Yesu. Rekashindiri baganda rabori, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we bless you, Jehovah. We bless you. We honor you because of your doing, in the name of Jesus. Rekashindiri baganda rabori.
Kuoshwa kwa damu ikutakasayo ya kondo siwe safi uonye upe mno umeoshwa kwa damu.
Your message to us is so clear, so certain. Thank you, Father, for everyone of us that is repenting, for everyone that is calling on your hand for salvation, for everyone, dear Lord of glory, that we are honoring you, my God, for thy call and for thy teaching, and even for thy revelation this hour, my Father. I honor you because you are doing it in our hearts. You are breaking our spirit. You are breaking our mind. You are breaking our hearts. You are sanctifying our souls. My Father, you are giving us a heart of flesh. Yes, dear Lord of glory, and removing even that heart of stone, my Father. We are standing, dear Master, in a praise of exalting you and not ashaming you. We are standing in a praise of honoring you because you are so mighty and you are so holy. I thank you because of your goodness. Thank you for this grace of salvation. Thank you because you are turning around our hearts. Thank you because you are transforming our spirits. Thank you, my Father, because your gracious hand is upon us. We give you glory, we give you praise, we give you honor in the name of Jesus. We are experiencing your heavy hand of blessing, your heavy hand of deliverance, your heavy hand of liberation, your heavy hand of redemption in the name of Jesus. We worship you because of your eternal blessing, even unto us in this sanctuary. We give you glory, we give you praise. We honor you because of restoring us and putting us together once again. Dear Lord of glory, in a way we get to the full knowledge of your salvation and of full knowledge of your light and your goodness. In Jesus' name we glorify you, we adore you, and we bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us give God a mighty clap and worship him because of his goodness as he continues to transform our hearts and our lives, that we may be in the full knowledge of his salvation. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Jehovah, because of giving us life, even eternal life. We honor your name. We adore you, Father. Now we're going to present ourselves before you, even with our offerings, Lord. How we pray that you may bless us, God, because this far you have brought us. This far you are our Ebenezer, O Jehovah God. This far we have come. Let us, dear Lord of glory, give unto you, even unto your ministration, for the sake of your kingdom, for the sake of your work, in the name of Jesus. You may be a people that have also gone out to preach this gospel, because for this sake we have been sent. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, receive our offerings, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us give God a precious hand of appreciation because of this great understanding in Jesus' name.
Hakuna likushindalo, unaweza yote. Hakuna kigumu kwako, unaweza yote. Unaweza Bwana. Hakuna kigumu kwako, unaweza yote. Hakuna likushindalo, unaweza yote. Hakuna kigumu kwako, unaweza yote, unaweza Bwana.